Hello children, welcome to yet another session of Geography Class 10, Climate Chapter Session 4. And before we commence, let us have a quick look at what we have studied in our previous session. In our previous session, we started with the southwest monsoon winds, and I told you because of the high pressure area over the oceans, the winds were initially moving from the southeast direction, which were called the southeast trade winds. As they crossed the equator, they got deflected due to the Coriolis force, and now they were called the southwest trade winds or southwest monsoon winds. Now children, I told you that the monsoon winds, they get bifurcated into two branches. The first branch, the Arabian Sea branch, and the second one, the Bay of Bengal branch. Now the Arabian Sea branch strikes the coast of Kerala on the 1st of June. And this strike, when it strikes, it is accompanied by thunder and lightning, which is called the burst of the monsoons. So this way, the coming of the monsoons, the onset of the monsoons come. Now, the windward side receives more rainfall. We have the Arabian, we have this Western Ghats. So the windward side is receiving more rainfall than the leeward side. And the rain shadow area, so the whole of this Coromandel coast does not get much rainfall from the southwest monsoons Arabian Sea branch. Now another branch of the Arabian Sea branch moves towards the Mumbai, north of Mumbai, and again relief rainfall occurs, and one branch moves towards the north and moves towards Gujarat, that you can see. Now this wind is parallel. Now you can see the Aravallis is parallel, and as such it is parallel. The southwest monsoon winds are parallel to the Aravallis, the Aravallis are not able to obstruct, and as such these winds move straight northwards without giving any rainfall to the Rajasthan. So Rajasthan remains dry, and the rest of the part, the windward side, gets more rainfall, that is in the south, and the leeward side, the Coromandel coast region, gets very scanty rainfall. Now the next Bay of Bengal branch, and as I said, as the branch moves, it is parallel to the Coromandel coast, and again it is not giving any rainfall to the Coromandel coast. So the Coromandel coast gets less rainfall because firstly the Arabian Sea branch is shedding most of its moisture in the windward side, and by the time it reaches the other side it is devoid of moisture, and the Bay of Bengal branch is parallel to the Coromandel coast and is again not giving any rainfall. Now as the Bay of Bengal branch proceeds, it strikes the Arakan Hills, which is in Myanmar, and then it gets deflected towards the Garo Khasi Hill region. Now children, this Garo Khasi Hill region is in the northeast region of, that is, Assam, Meghalaya. These winds, that is the Bay of Bengal branch of the southwest monsoon winds, get entrapped here, giving heavy rainfall on the windward side and less towards the leeward side. And your Mausinram and Cherrapunji is situated in the windward side, and as such they receive very, very heavy rainfall. After giving heavy rainfall in the northeast, these winds get deflected towards the west. The amount of moisture content in these winds, they get diminished as they are moving towards the west. So any city which is towards the west, they will get less rainfall in comparison to all the cities situated in the east. And by the time these winds move towards Rajasthan, it gets devoid of any moisture, and as such again Rajasthan is deprived of any rainfall with the Bay of Bengal branch also. So the Arabian Sea branch is not giving any rainfall because it is parallel, and the Bay of Bengal branch is also not giving any rainfall because by the time it reaches Rajasthan, it is devoid of any moisture. Okay, we had studied all this in our last session. Apart from that, we had also studied about the retreat of the monsoons. Now, during the retreat of the monsoons, it is marked by the October heat during the October season. Now, this retreating monsoon is generally the October and November season. So, what is the October heat? We had studied last time. And the October heat, it was marked by clear, cloudless sky, high temperature and high humidity, if you remember. Okay, so this was explained as the sultry and oppressive weather, which was referred to as the October heat. Now, this retreating monsoon season, it was the transition period between the monsoon season and the winters. So during this time, the low pressure became weak, and a high pressure area was starting to develop, and the winds were retreating, were leaving the nation and going, and Kerala was the last state to receive the rainfall, monsoon rainfall, and after which the monsoons left India and gone. So Kerala, I told you earlier, was the first and the last to receive the monsoon rains. Okay, so that was the retreating monsoon season. And another thing that happened during this season was the tropical cyclones. Now, this tropical cyclones was the low pressure area which developed in the Andaman Sea. And this low pressure, this tropical cyclone, starts moving towards the Coromandel coast and affects the coastal area. So heavy rainfall is experienced during this time, October, November, maybe due to the tropical cyclones which occurs in the Bay of Bengal. This causes heavy destruction and heavy rainfall, these tropical cyclones. And another thing which I told you last time, that these tropical cyclones are named by these eight countries which are surrounding the Indian Ocean: Bangladesh, India, Maldives, Myanmar, Oman, Pakistan, Sri Lanka and Thailand. They are one after the other, they are responsible to name these tropical cyclones. Okay, now today we will start with the northeast monsoon season, and this is the cold season now. So the cold weather season commences at the end of November and continues till March. The skies are relatively clear and dry weather. Night temperatures are low, especially in the northern India, but the days are pleasantly warm. The mean temperature in the northern plains is below 20 degrees and gets even lower in Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Punjab, Haryana. January is the coldest month and the temperature remains quite low during the winter months over the Indian subcontinent. Now the temperature keeps decreasing, and because of the low temperatures, a high pressure area is developed over the land, you can see. And the oceans, the sea around is cooler comparatively. So there is a low pressure area, I mean they are warm, the land is cold and the sea is comparatively warm, and a low pressure area is developing over the ocean. Now, winds always move from land to sea. And another thing is that the winds are always named from the direction they blow. Since in this case they are during the winter months, you can see the winds are moving from the high pressure area, which is in the northeast, towards the low pressure area. So they are named as the northeast trade winds or the northeast monsoon winds. You can call them the northeast monsoon winds also and the northeast trade winds also. Now, as they are moving, you can see they are mostly from the land region, so they are called offshore winds. And when they are called offshore winds, they are not carrying any moisture and they are generally dry. They do not carry any moisture, they are dry. As such, the major part of India does not get much rainfall from these northeast monsoon winds. Only a part of these northeast monsoon winds, when they move over the Bay of Bengal, they carry moisture, and when they strike the Coromandel coast, they bring heavy rainfall. So the Coromandel coast is able to get rainfalls during the winter but not in summer. So just let us have a comparative that this is the winter monsoon here and this is the summer monsoon here. And in the summer monsoon, the low pressure area is over the land. Winds from high pressure area is coming and they are the southwest monsoon winds. The reverse happens. In the winter months, a high pressure area is over the land and low pressure area is over the sea, and winds are moving from high pressure to low pressure area. I hope, children, this much is clear. Now we move ahead. Yes, you can see this. Okay, again a comparative study. You can see the southwest winds, they bring rainfall to the major part of India because they are coming from the sea, whereas the northeast monsoon winds, they are not coming from the sea, they are coming from the land, they do not carry moisture, so they remain dry. Only, I said, a part of the wind, these northeast winds, when they move over the Bay of Bengal, they carry moisture. When they strike the Coromandel coast, they give heavy rainfall here in the south coastal areas. Yes. Is this clear to you? Okay. Now, in this region, in this time, that is the winter months, only which region is getting rainfall? The south coastal regions are getting rainfall, whereas the north remains dry. But we do experience some rainfall in the north also during the winter season, and that is because of the western disturbances. So we are not getting rainfall from the northeast monsoons during the winter season. Instead, whatever rainfall we are getting, that is because of the western disturbances. Now children, what is this western disturbances? Now, western disturbances are temperate cyclones which are occurring in the Mediterranean Sea. Okay, you can see here, it's the Mediterranean Sea from where these temperate cyclones are coming. They are crossing, these temperate cyclones, they move over a very large area. Just in contrast with the tropical cyclones where they are affecting a small area, they move over a very large area. They are crossing the Caspian Sea, they are crossing Afghanistan, they are crossing Pakistan, and then they are entering India, giving rainfall to the Punjab, Jammu Kashmir, Western Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh. Okay, I hope you can see this. So these are depressions in the Mediterranean Sea. These winds are moving all this direction. They are covering such a huge area, crossing Afghanistan, crossing Pakistan, entering India, giving rainfall to वो पंजाब, हरियाणा, वेस्टर्न उत्तर प्रदेश, जम्मू कश्मीर. ओके, सो दैट वॉज वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस. सो आई होप यू नो द सोर्स. द नॉर्दर्न इंडिया इज रिसीविंग वट इज द सोर्स ऑफ विंटर रेनफॉल, दैट इज वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस. एंड साउथ इंडिया वट इज द सोर्स ऑफ विंटर रेनफॉल, इट इज नॉर्थ ईस्ट ट्रेड विंड्स. ओके, सो दिस मच इज क्लियर. नाउ वी कम टू द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ रेनफॉल. And distribution of rainfall, this is the annual distribution of rainfall in millimeters, and you can see that less than 500 millimeters of rainfall is experienced in where the light purple area, that is Rajasthan, Jammu and Kashmir, in all these areas the very less amount of rainfall occurs. Now between 500 to 1000 millimeters of rainfall is the next region. This is the rain shadow area, you can see, and is receiving less rainfall. Then it is, then the next one is the 2000 to 3000 millimeters of rainfall, and the rest part of India, this is what it is receiving. Maximum rainfall or more than that is received in the western side of the Western Ghats and in the northeast region, also the Garo Khasi Hill region and parts of Assam, and all these places, they are receiving between 3000 to 4000 or even more than 4000 millimeters of rainfall. So that was the annual rainfall which was received. Now coming up next, the difference between the tropical and the temperate cyclones should be known, and it is given in your books also. Children, you can see this is given in your, this from your own book. The tropical cyclones, they mostly largely occur during the summers, whereas the temperate cyclones, they occur during the winter season. Now the tropical cyclones, they are smaller in size, their shape is also circular, whereas they are oval in shape. The tropical cyclones develop over sea, temperate cyclones develop over continents. They develop in the tropical region, they develop in the temperate region, they bring heavy rainfall and strong winds in the Coromandel coast of India, and they bring light to moderate rainfall in the northwestern part of India under the influence of the westerly jet stream. So the jet streams, they help to the movement of these temperate cyclones, which are also called the western disturbances. They are affecting the western part of India, that is Punjab, Haryana, western Uttar Pradesh. Now children, let me tell you one thing. These winds, the western disturbances, they bring light rainfall and they are beneficial for wheat and barley. Is that clear? They are beneficial for the crops, wheat and barley. If you write Rabi crops, even then you get marks for it. Okay, apart from this, another question which is asked often, not in your books children, but important, this is from another book, please note down. The major features of the Indian monsoon, very important. Firstly, that the major part of the country is receiving rainfall from the southwest monsoon. So it is responsible for giving rainfall to the major part of India. Rainfall from the monsoons winds is variable and quite undependable. We cannot depend on the monsoons. One year it might rain heavily and cause floods, and the next year just might be a drought, hardly any rainfall. So it's highly undependable, it's variable, it varies from one place to the other. Then much rainfall is received in 3 to 4 months.
So it is not that the Indian monsoons, that is the monsoon, the southwest monsoon, is giving rainfall to till the entire year. It is only giving rainfall to 3 to 4 months. So the major rainfall is confined to 3 to 4 months. Rest of the year it is dry. Now the distribution of rainfall is highly uneven. When we say that the distribution of rainfall is highly uneven, we mean that one side there may be places which are getting heavy, very heavy rainfall, and yet there are places which are hardly receiving any rainfall. So this distribution of rainfall is highly uneven. Then Indian rainfall is controlled by orography, that is orographic rainfall, because of which the one side of the mountain is receiving very heavy rainfall, the other side is hardly receiving much rainfall. Apart from these points, you can write that the Indian monsoon is erratic in nature and it is highly undependable, that is mentioned there, it is erratic, it is uneven. So all these points are important. So with this, we'll continue with this in our next session. So keep study the chapter well, read it, and I hope you understand the concept of this chapter. So stay well, stay safe, and stay at home. Thank you.